हेलो हेलो, गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स. आई एम डॉक्टर अखिल शेख, वर्किंग एज एन असिस्टेंट प्रोफेसर इन तुलसीराम जी गायकवाड़ पाटिल कॉलेज ऑफ इंजीनियरिंग एंड टेक्नोलॉजी, नागपुर. वी स्टार्ट हियर लीनियर अलजेब्रा, व्हिच इज द इजिएस्ट एंड इम्पोर्टेंट टॉपिक इन मैथमेटिक्स, इन गेट मैथमेटिक्स. द टोटल वेटेज ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स इन गेट इज ईयर 15 मार्क्स. देर आर सम क्वेश्चन ऑफ 1 मार्क्स एंड देर आर सम क्वेश्चन ऑफ 2 मार्क्स. सो वी स्टार्ट हियर लीनियर अलजेब्रा. हियर व्हाट इज लीनियर अलजेब्रा? लीनियर अलजेब्रा इज ए ब्रांच ऑफ मैथमेटिक्स विच डील्स द स्टडी ऑफ थियरी ऑफ सिस्टम ऑफ लीनियर इक्वेशंस, मैट्रिसेस, डिटर्मिनेंट्स, वेक्टर स्पेस एंड लीनियर ट्रांसफॉर्मेशंस. In this topic, we'll study subtopics like matrix algebra, rank of matrix, system of linear equations, eigenvalues and eigenvectors, and Cayley-Hamilton theorem. Now here, the basic definition of matrix. What is matrix? A matrix is a rectangular arrays of numbers or objects arranged in rows and columns. For example, I just write a matrix of order 3 by 4. Here, some of the applications of matrices. Matrices are used to solve system of simultaneous linear equations. Matrices are used in computer graphics. Matrices are applied in the study of electrical circuits, quantum mechanics, and optics. Matrices are also used to solve AC network equations in electrical circuits. कर दिया ऐसे, कनेक्ट कहां से हुआ? मैट्रिसेस आर यूज टू सॉल्व एसी नेटवर्क्स इक्वेशंस इन इलेक्ट्रिकल सर्किट्स. देयर आर सम टाइप्स ऑफ मैट्रिसेस व्हिच इज कॉल्ड एज स्पेशल टाइप्स ऑफ मैट्रिसेस. हियर फर्स्ट वन इज हियर स्क्वेयर मैट्रिक्स. अ स्क्वेयर मैट्रिक्स इज एन एम बाय एन मैट्रिक्स इन विच एम इक्वल्स टू एन, मीन्स नंबर ऑफ रोज एंड नंबर ऑफ कॉलम्स आर इक्वल. सो वी कॉल एज स्क्वेयर मैट्रिक्स. नेक्स्ट डायगोनल मैट्रिक्स. A square matrix in which all of diagonal elements are zero is called a diagonal matrix. Here, of diagonal elements means these are the diagonal elements a1, a2, a2, an. Above the diagonal elements and below the diagonal elements are called as off diagonal elements. Here, for example, I just write here a equals to diagonal of a1, a2 up to an. This is the another notation to write the matrix. I write this matrix here. This is the diagonal matrix. These are a1, a2, a3 up to an are diagonal elements, and of diagonal elements are zero. And shortly, it can be written as diagonal of a1, comma a2 up to an. Now, some of the properties of diagonal matrix. Here, diagonal of XYZ plus diagonal of PQR. If there are two matrices or two diagonal matrices, then we can simply add their diagonal elements, means it becomes diagonal of x plus p, y plus q, z plus r. The multiplication of diagonal elements, diagonal of XYZ into diagonal of PQR, these are two diagonal matrices. Their multiplication is simply the multiplying its corresponding diagonal elements, which is here diagonal of xp, yq, r, z. Now, next one here, inverse of diagonal matrix, diagonal of xyz, whole inverse, nothing but diagonal of 1 by x, 1 by y, 1 by z, means just we take the inverse of diagonal elements, nothing else. Next here, transpose of diagonal elements here, diagonal matrix, which is here, diagonal of xyz transpose is diagonal of xyz, means transpose is same for diagonal matrix. Now here, this fifth one is the important property, diagonal of xyz raised to the power n is here, diagonal of x raised to power n, y raised to power n, and z raised to power n. It means that we just taking the respective power to the diagonal elements. Now here, determinant of diagonal elements of xyz is nothing but multiplication of diagonal elements, means determinant of diagonal of xyz is equals to x into y into z. Now here, this is another property, eigenvalues of diagonal matrix xyz are nothing but its diagonal elements, that is x, y, and z. Now, upper triangular matrix, this will be used to find the rank of matrix. A square matrix whose lower of diagonal elements are zero is called upper triangular matrix. For example, here I just write this matrix here. This A, B, F, these are principal diagonal elements, and below the diagonal elements is called as lower of diagonal elements are zero. Now here, next here, singular matrix. A square matrix A is said to be singular if determinant of A equals to zero. For singularity of matrices, the matrix should be a square. Next one here, non-singular matrix. A square matrix A is said to be non-singular if determinant of A is not equal to zero. This is useful to find the inverse of the matrix. Inverse of the matrix exists only when the matrix is non-singular. Well, we can see that determinant of A is not equal to zero. Next one here. This is the new definition of matrices. Trace of a matrix. The sum of principal diagonal elements of a square matrix is called as trace of a matrix. The properties of trace of matrix here. Trace of lambda A. Here lambda is a constant term. So it is equal to lambda times trace of A. Here A and B are matrices. So trace of A plus B means sum of trace of two matrices, nothing but trace of A plus trace of B. Again, trace of multiplication of two matrices, nothing but AB equals to trace of BA. Means trace of multiplication of two matrices commutative, that is trace of AB equals to trace of BA. Next here, symmetric matrix. A square matrix A is said to be symmetric if A transpose equals to A. For example, in this case, matrix A equals to, here upper of diagonal elements and lower of diagonal elements are overlapping, means here this is H, H, this element is here G, this is G, F, F, means if the lower and upper of diagonal elements are overlapping, then we can say that the matrix is symmetric. The properties here, A transpose equals to A, then we can say that the matrix is symmetric. Next definition here, skew symmetric matrix. A square matrix A is said to be skew symmetric if A transpose equals to minus A. Here transpose means we just interchanging rows into columns, then we call as transpose of the matrix. In that case, the principal diagonal elements are all zero and lower and upper of diagonal elements are overlapping with negative sign. Next here, next definition here, orthogonal matrix. A square matrix A is said to be orthogonal if A into A transpose equals to I. Here I is identity matrix. Now here, if A is orthogonal, then determinant of A equals to 1 always. Means if the determinant of the given matrix is unity, then we can directly say that the given matrix is orthogonal. Then in that case, we didn't have to check A transpose equals A into A transpose equals to I. We just check determinant. If it is 1, then we can say that it is the orthogonal. For example, we can say that the unit matrix or identity matrix is always orthogonal matrix. Now, conjugate of a matrix. The matrix obtained from given matrix capital A, on replacing its elements by the corresponding conjugate complex numbers, is called conjugate of A and is denoted by A bar. Means conjugate matrix is for complex matrix. Now, properties of conjugate matrix. A double bar equals to A, means conjugate of conjugate matrix, again the given matrix. A plus B complete bar equals to A bar plus B bar. A into B bar equals to A bar into B bar. Here A, B, A bar, B bar are conjugate matrix. Now A bar equals to A if A is a real matrix, means all elements of given matrix capital A are real, then we can say that A bar equals to A. And A bar equals to minus A if A is purely imaginary matrix, means all elements of this matrix A are imaginary, then A bar equals to minus A. Now here, conjugate transpose of matrix. The transpose of the conjugate of a matrix capital A is called transpose conjugate of A and is denoted by A bar transpose, or simply we can write here A raised to the power theta. This is conjugate transpose of a matrix. Now, some of the properties of conjugate of matrix, which is here A raised to the power theta, raised to the power theta, again we get simple A. A plus B raised to the power theta, nothing but A raised to theta plus B raised to the power theta. Most of the properties of conjugate matrix and transpose of matrix, both are same. Now here, K A raised to the power theta equals to K bar into A raised to the power theta if K is complex number. K bar means replacing I by minus I. If K is real, then we get K into A raised to the power theta. Now here, A B raised to the power theta is equals to B raised to theta into A raised to the power theta. Now here, these are similar properties of transpose of matrix. Here, A transpose means transpose of matrix is nothing but the given matrix. Here, A plus B transpose equals to A transpose plus B transpose. K A transpose equals to K into A transpose. Here, K is a real number. Here, A B transpose is B transpose into A transpose. Just remember the property number 4 of these two terms, means A B raised to the theta is not A raised to theta into B raised to theta. It is here B raised to theta into A raised to theta. The same manner, A B transpose equals to, first we write here last element, means B transpose into A transpose. Now, next definition here, Hermitian matrix. Matrix A is said to be Hermitian if A raised to the power theta equals to A. Now here, skew Hermitian matrix. In the Hermitian matrix, capital A is the complex matrix, and in symmetry, in singular symmetric and skew symmetric matrix, A was real matrix. Here, skew Hermitian matrix. A matrix A is said to be skew Hermitian if A raised to the power theta equals to minus A. Next, unitary matrix. A square matrix capital A is said to be unitary if A raised to the power theta equals to A inverse. Or simply we can say that A into A raised to the power theta equals to A, equals to I. I is here identity matrix. Now, next definition here, adjoint of matrix. This is the important definition for finding inverse of matrix. a equals to the given matrix is 2 by 2 a b c d, then adjoint of a. To find adjoint of a, we just replace these principal diagonal elements and taking minus sign to remaining elements. Now this is the general definition of adjoint of matrix. Adjoint of A is nothing but the transpose of matrix of cofactors, and cofactors is nothing but cofactor equals to minus 1 raised to the power I plus j into minor of the matrix. Now these are properties of adjoint of matrix. Here adjoint of AB means adjoint of product of two matrices is nothing but adjoint of B into adjoint of A. And we know that here matrix multiplication is not commutative, so this cannot be written as adjoint of A into adjoint of B. Means adjoint of AB is only equals to adjoint of B into adjoint of A. Now determinant of adjoint of A equals to determinant of matrix A raised to the power n minus 1. Now inverse of matrix, this is a basic definition of inverse of matrix. If capital A is any square matrix, then A inverse equals to 1 upon determinant of A into adjoint of A. And what is adjoint of A? This is nothing but transpose of matrix of cofactors. And the condition is that here the matrix A is non-singular, or simply we can say that determinant of A is not equal to 0 to inverse, to exist the inverse of the matrix. Now properties of inverse of matrix: A into A inverse equals to A inverse into A equals to I, that is identity matrix. Now here again AB raised to the power minus 1 or AB inverse is not equals to A inverse into B inverse, but we write it in terms of first writing last term is B inverse into A inverse. We extend this property for three matrices. If it is A B C inverse, then we write here we written as C inverse into B inverse into A inverse. Next here, properties of determinants. Here first property here, if any row or column of a matrix A is completely zero, then determinant of the given matrix capital A equals to zero. If any two rows or columns of a matrix capital A are identical, identical means any two rows or two columns are same, then the determinant is zero again. Now determinant of transpose of matrix equals determinants of A. Next property here, determinant of A plus B is not equals to determinant of A plus determinant of B. Now next one here, rank of a matrix. This is M1 means method 1. In method 1, a number small r is said to be rank of a matrix capital A if, first point, there is at least one square submatrix of capital A of order r whose determinant is not equal to 0. And second property here, the determinant of any square submatrix of order r plus 1 and above should be 0. Means if the given matrix having order r or rank r, then we can say that the matrix of above order r plus 1 and above should be 0. This is the first method to find the rank of the matrix. Now the second method is easier method. First of all, reduce the given matrix to an equivalent form, or we can say that an upper triangular form, by using elementary row transformations. Then the number of non-zero rows is the rank of the matrix. Now, properties of rank of matrix. Here, first property here, rank of AB. If there are two matrices, then rank of AB is less than or equals to minimum of rank of A and rank of B. Second property, rank of A transpose equals to rank of A, means any elementary transformations do not change the rank of the given matrix. If A is n by n matrix, means it is square matrix, and determinant of A is not equal to 0, then rank of A equals to n. The simple and well-known example of matrix of order n and rank n is nothing but the unit matrix or identity matrix. Identity matrix is the example of diagonal matrix, scalar matrix, non-singular matrix, as well as the environment matrix whose rank is n. Now, for any matrix capital A of order m by n, here m is row, n is column, then rank of the matrix A is less than or equals to minimum of m comma n. Here m is number of rows, n is number of columns. Means there is the possibility rank is less than or it may be equals to minimum of m comma n. Now, rank of A plus B is again less than or equals to rank of A plus rank of B. As discussed earlier in point number 2, the elementary transformations do not change the rank of the matrix. Means by using elementary row transformations or by using elementary column transformations, the rank of the given matrix does not change. Now, depending on these definitions and some properties, we start here examples. These all examples has been asked in previous GATE examinations, and these are simple examinations, simple examples here. Here, example one here, this is the question. Let A, B, C, D be n by n matrices, each with non-zero determinant. If A, B, C, D equals to I, then B inverse is. Means it means that here A, B, C, D are four matrices whose order is n by n. Means matrix multiplication is possible because order is same here, or we can say that square matrices. Now we have given that A, B, C, D means product of these four matrices equals to identity I. So we have to find B inverse, and options are here A, C, D, C, D, A, DCA, ADC. Now here we use the concept of inverse, and we use the property of inverse. Here solution. We have given that ABCD equals to I, identity matrix. Simply taking inverse on both sides. So we get here ABCD raised to the power minus 1 equals to I raised to minus 1. Now here, by using property of inverse of matrix, this A, B, C, D inverse is written as B inverse, means starting from right hand side, B inverse, C inverse, B inverse, A inverse equals to I. I is here identity matrix. inverse of I is again I, transpose of identity again I. Now here, first of all, I have to remove this D inverse. Our aim here is to find the value of D inverse. So I have to remove here D inverse, C inverse, and A inverse. So we know that here A into A inverse equals to I, means identity. So to remove D inverse, just P multiplying by D. And we know that matrix multiplication is not commutative. So be careful when we multiplying by any matrix. So P multiplying by D. So we get here D, D inverse, C inverse, B inverse, A inverse equals to D into I. Now D into D inverse, this is nothing but identity matrix I, and I into any matrix, we get the same matrix. So I into C inverse, again C inverse, remaining is here B inverse into A inverse equals to D, D into I again is D. Next here, again we have to remove C inverse, again P multiplying by C. So C into C inverse, B inverse, A inverse equals to C into D. So again, C into C inverse is identity I. I into B inverse, again B inverse. So it remains here, B inverse into A inverse equals to C into D. Next here, I have to multiply, post multiply by A. So post multiplying by A, we get here B inverse, A inverse into A equals to CDA. So A into A inverse, or A inverse into A equals to identity matrix I. So A inverse A is I, identity matrix. So B inverse into I equals to B inverse. So we get here CDA. The option is B. Our option is here B, means CDA. Now in this case, I have just taken first pre-multiplying by D. But this is not necessary to take pre-multiplying first. We can take post-multiplying by A inverse first. Means here, we can post-multiplying by A. So in that case, A inverse into A will become I. And then pre-multiplying by D and pre-multiplying by C, we will get the same result. Then, first example depends on inverse of matrix. Second one is depend on properties of determinant. So, the question is here, the determinant of matrix A is 5 and the determinant of matrix B is 40. Then the determinant of matrix A into B is. Now I have given that mathematically, I just write here determinant of A equals to 5 and determinant of B equals to 40. Now we know that here property of determinant here. Determinant of A into B equals to A into B. Determinant of A into determinant of B. So this is equals to determinant of A 5 is 40. So 5 into 40 is 200. So answer will be here 200. This is the simple property of determinant. Now, the matrix A equals to, this is the 4 by 4 matrix, A 0, 3, 7, 2, 5, 1, 3, 0, 0, 2, 4, 0, 0, 0, and B has determinant of A equals to 100 and trace of A equals to 14. This is the given data. The value of determinant of A minus B is 3, 2, 5, 7. The value of determinant of A minus B or determinant of B minus A, both are same, which will get the positive value. Now here, trace of matrix means nothing but the sum of principal diagonal elements, nothing but the trace of the matrix A. So here we have given that determinant of A equals 100. So we have to find which is right here. Determinant of A equals to given matrix A0372513002400B. Now here, there is the property of determinant. If we have to solve determinant of higher order, more than of order 3, so we can use this property to reduce the given matrix of higher order in terms of simple 2 by 2 or 3 by 2, 3 by 3 form. Now here, if you observe that this element in second row, that is 5, the elements above row and below the row are a 0. So we can remove this second column and second row, and we just write 5 into, I'm just writing here 5 into removing second row, second column. So we just write here minus 1^2 + 2. Here 2 stands for second row, plus again 2 stands for second column. Right here, minus 1^2 + 2 into 5. After removing second row, second column, writing the remaining elements in determinant form. This remaining elements here, A, 3, 7, next here 0, 2, 4, 0, 0, B. Next, this minus 1^4 is plus 1, this 5, keep it as it is. Now next here, the elements below A are 0, means we can remove first column and first row. For that purpose, we just write A into positional value of this term is minus 1^4, first row, first column, writing the remaining elements, which is here 2, 4, 0, B. Now, this is the 2 by 2 matrix, and we can easily find its determinant. Determinant is here, twice B minus 0 means twice B. This is 5A into twice B. Again, determinant of matrix A is 100, which was given. I just write here 100 equals to 5A into twice B, which is here 5 to the 10. 10 tens are 100, means AB equals to 10. In this case, it is not compulsory to take this element to reduce the given determinant in terms of 2 by 2 form. In this case, we observe that this B, if the previous element of this B in fourth row are all 0. So in that case also, I can remove fourth row and fourth column. In that case, I just take here B into positional value of B means minus 1^4, fourth row, fourth column is minus 1^4, 4 plus 4. Writing the remaining elements means A, 0, 3, 2, 5, 1, 0, 0, 2. Then, in next case, we can remove this third row, means this third row, third column. We get here 2 into minus 1^3 plus 3, and remaining elements in terms of determinant form A, 0, 2, 5. In that case, we get the value of determinant here 5A. My previous one here, this 2 into B means 5 to the 10, 10 AB. Then, here we find AB equals to 10 from given determinant, and we are given here trace of matrix A is 14. ट्रेस इज नथिंग बट द सम ऑफ प्रिंसिपल डायगोनल एलिमेंट्स ऑफ ए. मींस हियर दिस ए 5 2 बी दीज आर प्रिंसिपल डायगोनल एलिमेंट्स इज सम नथिंग बट पायलट ट्रेस ऑफ ए मैट्रिक्स. नाउ सिंपलीफाइंग द टर्म्स वी गेट ए प्लस बी प्लस 5 + 2 = 7. Then shifting 7 on other side, we get 40 minus 7 is 7. So a plus b equal to 7. We get here equation 2. Now to solve these two equation 1 and 2, there is long and tedious method. In that case, we substitute the value of a from equation 2 in equation 1. Simplifying the equation, we get the value of a. Then finding the value of b like this. But in this case, we have to find the values of a and b as early as possible. So in that case, when you observe that this a into b equals to 10, so how many possibilities are there? There are two possibilities. First one here, 10 into 1, 10. It means that a will be 10, b will be 1, or a is 1, b is 10. This is one possibility. Second one here, 5 2s are 10, means in that case a is 5, b is 2, or a is 2, b is 5. But when we assume equation 2, in that case a plus b equal to 7. So in first case here, 10 plus 1 is 11. So this first case, a first possibility is not possible. So we observe second possibilities. 5 into 10 is 10. We satisfy equation 1. 5 plus 2, 7. We satisfy equation 2. Means the possible values of A and B are A equals to 5 and B equals to 2. Or A equals to 2, B equals to 5. Now we have to find determinant of A minus B, which is here 5 minus 2 equals to 3. Now, next example here. Given an orthogonal matrix, we have given the matrix of 4 by 4 order. A equals to 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, 1, minus 1, minus 1, 1, minus 1, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, minus 1. Then A transpose complete inverse is. Means here we have to use the definition of orthogonal matrix. Here we have to remember the definition of orthogonal matrix. So we have given here A is an orthogonal matrix. So we know that A into A transpose equals to I. Now here we are interested to find the value of A transpose inverse. So taking inverse on both sides. So A transpose complete inverse equals to I inverse. And I is here identity matrix. We know that inverse of identity matrix, again the identity matrix. So I inverse again I. So answer will be here identity matrix I. Now, next example here. Given that the determinant of the matrix 1, 3, 0, 2, 6, 4, minus 1, 0, 2 is minus 12. In this case, we are given the determinant of the given matrix. Now, the determinant of the matrix 2, 4, 2, 6, 0, 4, 12, 8, minus 2, 0, 4 is. This example has been asked for 2 marks. This is a simple example. Now here just we use the property of determinant. Now in this case, we consider this example, this determinant. When we observe, in first row 2 is multiple, 2 is common. In second row also is multiple of 2. Again third row, it is also multiple of 2. So taking 2 common from first row, second row and third row. So we write just here 2 into 2 into 2, and remaining domain is here. We have taken common 2 from first row, it remains here 1 3 0. 2 is taken common from second row, it remains 2 6 4. Again taking 2 common from third row, it remains here -1 0 2. So it is 2 cube 2 cube is nothing but 8, into the value of this determinant is nothing but given, which is here -12. So -12 into 8 is nothing but -96. This is the final answer. Now these are some examples depending on given definitions. Now next one here, homework. Here the product of matrices PQ inverse into P is, there are 4 options: P inverse, Q inverse, P inverse, Q inverse, P, PQ, P inverse. To solve the first homework, here we have to use property of inverse of matrix, then you will get its answer. Now here the sum of the eigenvalues of the matrix given below is, means this is the given matrix. Now here this is the new concept of eigenvalues. The sum of eigenvalues is nothing but the trace of the matrix. In this case, we know that the trace of a matrix is nothing but the sum of diagonal elements of the matrix. The same manner, the sum of the eigenvalue is nothing but the trace of the given matrix. So we have to just find the trace of the matrix, nothing but the sum of the eigenvalues. We will get its answer. Thank you. Thank you, class.